A viewer recently contacted me asking about square and circular neutral density filters. How are square and circular ND filters different? Is square somehow better than circular, or vice versa? In this video, I'm going to break down the differences between square and circular and offer advice for when one may be better than the other. Stick around. Good to see you as always. My name is Todd. I make videos here on YouTube about photography. All right, before we begin, quick shout out to Breakthrough Photography because they were nice enough to hook me up with everything that you see here in front of me, including their X100 filter holder. This is a square and rectangular filter holder that is compatible with all lenses from 15 millimeters and up. And inside the holder right now, I have their 10-stop X4 solid ND, and that is in the first slot in the filter holder. This has two slots, and in the empty slot out here, I can add another solid ND if I want to, or I can add an effect filter like this. Now, this is 100 by 150 millimeters. This one here is 100 millimeters square. And this is a graduated filter. This is a 2-stop X4 graduated filter. And this is very similar to the graduated filter tool in Lightroom or Capture One. I mean, this is really what those tools are inspired by, where you can darken the sky or darken the ground or you know, kind of bring down some of the hotness of the sun in your shot. This is what filters like this are great for, because they help balance out some of that exposure in the moment when you are creating an image. And this just slides right into the front slot in front of the solid ND. And you can also flip it around and insert it in reverse as well. And in addition to all this, Breakthrough Photography also hooked me up with their X4 circular polarizer. Now, if you've never heard of Breakthrough Photography before, in my opinion, they make some of the highest quality, most color accurate filters out there. I know that sounds like a plug and it sounds like a sponsored bit, but no, they are not paying me to say that. I'm saying it because I happen to know it's true. And I know it's true because I own and paid for it with my own money the 105 millimeter version of this CPL. I have a much larger version with a different filter holder that I have. And I also own the circular version of the X4 ND. Plus, I've actually tested their filters head to head against other filters. You may remember a while back, I made a solid ND comparison video where I compared a bunch of different ones, and the Breakthrough Photography X4 was one of the top filters in that review. So again, thank you to Breakthrough Photography for supporting this channel and for providing me with gear to be making this video today. All right, so let's get into it and talk about the difference between circular and square. Circular ND filters may be used for all types of photo and video work. They're simple to use because they screw directly onto the front of a lens, or they can also attach magnetically if using a magnetized filter system. Circular filters are typically less expensive as well compared to square because less material is used in their construction and they don't require any additional hardware like this in order to be mounted. Square filters, on the other hand, are more specialized. They're bigger, a little more awkward, and more expensive when you add up the cost of each component, including the filter, the holder, plus the adapter ring. Square filters are mostly marketed to and used by landscape photographers. So all that said, if circular filters may be used for just about anything, including landscape photography, why do square filters like these even exist? I mean, is there some kind of tipping point when a circular filter is no longer doing the job and a square filter would be better? Well, that, I think, is the key question. So let's take a look at the benefits of square filters. If you are shooting wide angle images using a full frame camera and a focal length somewhere between 15 and 24 millimeters, filters, both square and circular, can magnify the amount of darkening you see around the edges and corners of your images. This is known as optical vignette. Filters can magnify optical vignette, but they can also introduce mechanical vignette. Mechanical vignette is additional vignette layered on top of optical vignette. And it happens when using filters that are blocking the lens, a wide angle lens, from being able to see wide. Mechanical vignette is difficult, if not impossible, to fix because it doesn't just turn the corners of the image dark, it actually makes them black, which means that Unfortunately, you typically have to crop an image that includes mechanical vignette. Mechanical vignette most often occurs when stacking a circular polarizer with an ND filter, which is a common thing to do in landscape photography for removing reflections, increasing vibrancy, and dynamic range. Some photographers work around this problem by purchasing one circular filter that combines neutral density and polarization, so you're not having to stack two different filters. For example, there's the Dark CPL from Breakthrough Photography. Polar Pro also makes a line of quartz line filters that includes options for this, as does Freewell with their magnetic filter system. Square filters are designed to be stacked. They're wider than the front of the lens, so you may stack two or even three square or rectangular filters out here in front of a lens, even a wide angle lens shooting at 16 millimeter full frame, and you will get little to no mechanical vignette compared to the same number of filters if you were to attempt the same using a circular filter. Square is faster when using multiple lenses in the field. Once you have square filters and a holder, all you need then are inexpensive adapter rings for each lens you own to quickly move filters from one lens to another. This for me is fantastic when doing landscape photography, for if I'm experimenting with different focal lengths, everything from wide angle to telephoto, I can quickly change the lens and then within seconds remount all the same filters that I had attached previously. Square filters may be easily added or removed. I mean, when you don't need a filter, you just pull it right out of the holder. Or if you need to switch filters, say for example, you're shooting with a 6-stop ND and you want to change over to 10, you just pull the filter out and then you drop in a new one. Now, where I have found this ability to add and remove filters to be especially helpful is when using super dark ND filters like this one, which is 10 stops. Because what you have to do when shooting with a 10-stop ND, because oftentimes the 10-stop ND is so dark that the camera isn't able to focus, it's not able to see what it is that you're shooting, what you oftentimes have to do is lift the square ND out, meter the scene, figure out what normal exposure is, also focus the camera, then you take that shutter speed, you plug it into an app like this one that is made by Lee Filters. I just happen to really like the user interface of this app. You plug that shutter speed in, you plug in the density of the filter you're using, and then you know what shutter speed to use on your camera. So then you dial in the appropriate shutter speed, the newly calculated shutter speed, drop the 10-stop ND back in, and keep shooting. And I mean, I know I've talked about this before on this channel, but speed and ease of use is really important to me when I'm out in the field shooting. For them, I don't have an excuse for not changing lenses and trying something different. The faster I'm able to swap lenses and change filters, the more images I typically create, which gives me more options to choose from later in post. Square filters are also the only type of filter you may use with ultra wide angle lenses. I'm talking about lenses with focal lengths of 14 millimeters full frame or wider. Those lenses have convex shaped glass in the front without any circular filter threads. So circular filters aren't even compatible with them. You have to use square filters and specialized square filter holders that can mount to those types of lenses. Square filter holders are rotatable. This is especially helpful when using rectangular filters like these, and you want to try and balance the exposure by darkening the sky or darkening the foreground in your shot or darkening the middle of the image. And you need to line up your graduated filter with the horizon line in your shot. So as you can see, there are some definite advantages to square filters. However, like everything else, they aren't perfect. Here are some of their downsides to be aware of. First, square filters can be bulky and awkward. They take up more room in a backpack compared to circular filters. And if you're carrying a carry-on backpack, you know, with a bunch of gear in it when you're flying or when hiking, hardware like this, or like this box here, this is the Summit system from Polar Pro. I mean, they take up quite a bit of space in your bag, and that space that you know, you could be using for another lens or for some other piece of gear that you need to bring with you. Square filters can be more fragile. I mean, personally, I've never broken one of these, but when you consider that, you know, circular filters have a brass or aluminum frame around them protecting them, square filters basically have nothing around the edges here, I can see how some photographers might accidentally crack one. Third disadvantage, square filters are unfortunately more susceptible to light leaks compared to circular. Reason being, I mean, a circular filter, it threads right onto the front of a lens. There's no way that light can then get behind the circular filter and cause any kind of streaks in your shot. Square filters are more susceptible because they're not flush with the front of the lens. They stand away from the front of the lens a little bit. And that's why it's really important when you start using square NDs to make sure that the square NDs you get have some type of padding, some type of protection that's here, you know, affixed to the back of the square filter. I mean, quality square NDs like this X401 from Breakthrough Photography will absolutely have this. And the reason this is here is because then when you insert the square filter into the holder, and then you turn around and you look through, you know, openings like areas like here and then down here on the bottom of the filter, you don't see anything. Like, it's completely covered by that padding that's on the back of the filter, and that helps prevent the light from getting in behind the filter. But obviously what you have to be careful of and you have to make sure of is that when you're inserting the square filter, just make sure that it's perfectly lined up over the opening of the lens. Fourth disadvantage, square filters are more expensive because more material, more glass is being used in their construction because they're bigger than circular NDs. And then you have the cost of the holder plus the adapter rings as well. All right, so final thoughts and recommendations. I mean, for me, I use both circular and square. I prefer using circular when shooting video outdoors or handheld photography in a more kind of casual run and gun style fashion. I prefer using square filters, however, when doing landscape photography with a tripod. In those situations, I'm just being more methodical. I'm switching lenses and I'm experimenting with different strengths of ND filters. So my advice, if you're just getting started with your photography and you want to start experimenting with filters and you're trying to decide between square and circular, I think circular filters are the simplest to get started with and to learn how to use. They're also comparatively cheaper as well, and you can use them for all types of photo and video work. But once you get a handle on things, and if you're buying filters specifically for landscape photography, square gives you the most creative options when stacking filters and better vignette performance when shooting wide angle on a full frame camera. If you're currently shopping for either a circular ND filter or a square filter system like the X100 from Breakthrough Photography, I've linked to a number of recommendations in the description below. In general, overall, I mean, this is a pretty big topic and I've attempted to simplify and condense the information as much as possible. But if there's something I didn't cover or you have additional questions, feel free to leave a comment below or feel free to head over to Instagram. You can follow me over at Instagram and send me a direct message through there. Thanks again to Breakthrough Photography for providing me with their X100 holder and their excellent line of X4 filters. I greatly appreciate your support. And if you enjoyed this video, if you learned something from it, please remember to take the time to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, I know there's plenty of you out there that watch videos on this channel, but you have not taken the time to just, you know, tap that subscribe button below. If you haven't done so, please just take a moment and do so. I would greatly appreciate it. And then we can stay in touch in the future. Appreciate your time as always. See you next time.